but it policy. This is a one small topic. What is audit policy? Audit policy defines account limits for set of users for use one or two resources. Means here audit policy defines audit policy depends.
Mute. I am muting all except sir.
Set up. Set up users of one hour more resources. Means here, what is the use of audit policy? Means audit policy defines account limits per set of users of group to group of one or more resources. Means here this account policy is deciding account limits of users. Means for example, previously we are discussing DNS server. If you are creating any group in DNS server, that time you are giving some permission to users, means clients. For example, in one office have accountants, means accountant division. Now here, this, for example, purpose I am telling, this accountant division, now they are preparing employee salary payslip. So that purpose, they are accessing this account database, and at same time they are accessing employees attendance. Employee attendance means here, if they want to prepare this means employees pay slip, that purpose they are they are accessing accountant database, and same time they are accessing employees attendance. Means depending on that employee attendance, they are preparing each and every employee payslip. Means here, for example, this accountant try to access any another database. Means for example, they want to access purchase department or sales department. That time we are restricting by using that permissions in DNS. Same thing here also, audit policy also defines accountant limits. For example, in this limits means when their data is flow, that time any occurrence is any means any errors is coming, that time automatically it is detecting and it is notifying them. This is the audit policy. Audit policy means simple definition is, it defines accountant limits for set of users of group to group of access one or more resources. Means one group want to access one resource or two resources. Means here this accountant group try to access this accountant database resource, same time they want to access employees attendance resource. So that purpose here they are giving some permissions. So that permissions same like here also, this audit policy also defines accountant limits. Means you are a accountant, means you are a client, you have this much of limits, means you access this pipes only. That type of facility this audit policy providing. Means this is network related, this is database related, don't mix both. For example purpose I am explaining this one. Next one is IPC. Internet Protocol Security. Generally, we are using IP, Internet Protocol. Actually, this internet protocol don't have security features. That is the disadvantage. So now we are protect this internet protocol by using IPsec. This IPsec is providing security by using confidentiality, integrity, and authentication. By using these three features, it is providing security to this IP, internet protocol. Means here this IPsec is developed by Internet Engineering Task Force. Means here Internet Engineering Task Force is designing this framework. What is that IPsec? IPsec means here Internet Protocol Security. This Internet Protocol Security, it is designed by Internet Engineering IETF. This IETF So this Internet Protocol Security is developed by IETF, Internet Engineering Task Force. This Internet Engineering Task Force is developing this one, and it is providing security by using integrity and confidentiality and authentication. Now we are discussing the tasks. What is the integrity? What is the confidentiality? And what is the authentication? Now why we are using this IP segments? Generally internet protocol don't have security features, so we are add that security features by using this IPsec. This IPsec is developed by IETF, Internet Engineering Task Force. Internet Engineering Task Force, this task force is developing this IPsec framework. So this IPsec is providing that security features by using integrity, authentication, confidentiality. Here, this IPsec is providing security by using integrity and authentication and confidentiality. So by using three, it is providing security to internet protocol. So first we are discussing integrity. When data is transferring from transferring in internet, that time if any person is try to access that data, that time he is copying data and he is add any extra copy in our this data packet, that time it is immediately detected. Means, for example, here this person is the sender, this person is the receiver, sender, receiver. Now data is transferring from here to here by using internet. So now data transferring from here to here in pocket mode. So that end, if any another third person try to access that pocket or try to access that pockets by using hash file and he preparing any duplicate file, immediately this IPsec is not allowing that duplicate file. That is the advantage. Means integrity means here, if any person try to access this data, actually data is transferring from here to here by pocket mode, and when that third person try to access the data by using hash file, that time and this person is preparing any duplicate file and that file is adding in this pockets, that time means that person is creating one duplicate what is that pocket, and he try to add that, that time generally when we are sending data from each other by using pockets, that time it is assigning each packet one number. Now this packets is moving from here to here, that time this person is accessing the packets by using hash file and is preparing duplicate and try to send. That time when already we are assigning, means this security is assigning number name. So this third person try to add any packet, that time this IPsec is opposing, means already the numbering is sequence 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now this person is add any packet by using 3 number or 4 number. Actually already here 3 or 4 are present. Again he is add one packet by using this number, so that time it is opposing. Means this IPsec is opposing duplicate packets in data flow time. Means it is called integrity. Means all packets are integrated. If try to add any packet by using hash file, that time it is opposing that. This is the first one. Now this is the data sender and this is data receiver. Now we are send data from here to here by using network internet. So in this, when we are send data from here to here, that time by using this confidentiality, it is encrypting that data and it sends the data by using internet. After here it is decrypting. After the data is reached to this receiver, means this is the sender and this is the receiver. Means for example, this is the one computer, this is the one computer. Now this computer is send one data from here to here, means client to client. This is a client to client. If you have send any data from one client to another client, when this data is transferring in by using internet, that time here we are encrypting the data and we transfer the data, encrypted data. After here, here one device is decrypting the data and it reaches to this receiver. This is the one method. And means here confidential means if any person try to access this, then that person don't know who is sender, who is the receiver, what is the data. That person cannot accessing that one, and that person don't know who is the sender and who is the receiver. Authentication. For example, here this is the one computer and this is the other computer. Now we are send data from here to here by using internet. By using internet, that means it is allow data from sender to receiver. This allow the data from sender to receiver without encryption. Means here, for example, now this receiver is receiving data. So that time, that purpose, it is not maintaining any secure protocol. Means here we are sending, means it is verifying this data is coming for authenticated person or not. Means here, when we are send data, that time we are not encrypting. Simply we are sending data from here to here. That time this receiver is first verifying by using this IPsec this data I am receiving from authenticated person or not. So in this method we cannot encrypting the data. Simply we are sending the data from here to here. Means so when we are sending the data, that time this receiver is suspecting this data is coming from unknown person or known person. How they identify means this IPsec is providing the feature. It is verifying this data is coming from known person or unknown person. If this data is coming from known person, means it is sent that data. If this data is receiving, this receiver receiving the data from unknown person, means it is immediately blocking that one. Here, by using IPsec, this IPsec is providing security to internet protocol. Actually, this internet protocol don't have security features. And in this, this IPsec is transferring the data. Means, what are the features of the IPsec? Means, this IPsec is encrypting data. Encrypting data and decrypting data. and this epithet is provided with a verify authentication person sending data or on data or unknown person. Means here, first this IPsec have features to verify, means have features, it is encrypting data and it is decrypting data by using some hardware device, and again it is verifying at authentication, means this data is sending authentication person or unknown person. It is verified by using some protocols. IPsec means IPsec have these two features. Means it is also encrypting and decrypting the data by using some hardware, and it is also verifying this person, means this data is coming from known person or unknown person. It is verifying that data. It is verifying that and it is allowing the data. And another one is here, this IPsec is providing, means here IPsec provides security to router sending routing data. Means now we have sent one data, that time this router is routing the data, this router is sending routing data, that time this IPsec is providing security to this routing data, and it is properly reaching to the destination or not, and it is verifying and it is providing security to this data. Means this is the one feature in this IPsec. Means here IPsec is providing security to routing data. Means here this router is sending one routing data. That time this data is reached properly or not, it is verifying that one. And here it is providing security to is providing security to data without encryption. And another one is it is encrypted data and sent by using internet, and it is decrypting the data. And let's see, sender place this IPsec is encrypting the data. After that encrypted data is sending by using internet, after it is reached to the destination, here also have one hardware device. That device is decrypting the data. After that decrypted data is reached to computer. Now we are discussing this one. Means here IPsec has features, means it is providing security to routing data. and it is providing security to data without encryption. Means here it is only verifying that data is coming from known person or unknown person. And another one is here. This is the one client. This is the one client. So now we are saying this is the sender, data sender. Data sender. And this person is data receiver. Data receiver. Now it is providing more security to transferring the data by using internet. How it is providing internet or more security in internet means here. Now we are sending the data from here to here. That purpose here we are using one. Virtual LAN switch means VLAN switch. That we are using one switch. VLAN switch. And here also we are using one VLAN switch. VLAN switch. Now we are sending the data. That time this is the client. Now the client is sending the data. Means every machine is means in LAN. Every switch is connecting. Sorry, every computer is connecting to this switch. Now this is the switch. What is that? A virtual local area network. So, or sorry, this is a VPN. This is a VPN switch. And here also, this is VPN switch. Virtual private network switch. Now, this VPN switch is encrypting the data. Virtual private network switch. Now, the data is transferring from here to here. That purpose here. We are maintaining one tunneling from here to here. Tunneling means here what we are doing here. Internet is a public network. We are using public network and creating one private network. By using public network, we are creating one private network. Means here, physically this total is public network. In this public network, I am creating virtually one private network, and we are sending the data through this channel. Means here we are allocating some bandwidth for transferring data from here to here. This, if we are allocating some bandwidth for transferring data, receiving data, so that it is called tunneling. Tunnel. Means this tunnel is specially created for sending data and receiving data to this VPN to this VPN. Means nowadays multinational companies maintaining many offices in many countries. So that time they are sharing very important data. It is very high confidential data. So we are sending the data from one country to another country by using this network. If they are send the data in normal network, that time other companies try to accessing and they stole the data. So they are avoiding that situation by using this VPN, virtual private network. So in this they are using here this side. This is the one LAN. For example, this is Hyderabad, and this is the one LAN. For example, this Chennai. So now we are sending data from Hyderabad to Chennai or Hyderabad to New Delhi. Here, that purpose in this LAN, in Hyderabad LAN, here I am arranging here one VPN switch, virtual private network switch, and here also we are arranging one VPN switch, and from here to here we are arranging one tunnel. Now, if this computer is send data, that time that data is reached to this VPN. Now this VPN is encrypted the data. Generally, we are sending encrypted data by using normal internet. Normal internet also no problem. But here we want more secure. So that purpose here, Now say first you are encrypting the data, and that encrypted data we are sent by using one special channel, means others cannot access this channel. It is called a tunneling. This tunnel only specially for this mission, means this Hyderabad center to this Chennai center, in between we are arranging one channel. This channel means this is called a tunnel. Now here we are providing two securities. One is that we are encrypted. After that encrypted data by sending by special channel, means this value is specially assigned for this center. And here we are creating one tunnel. This tunnel is providing sending data, receiving data from Chennai. So here means here this is called a virtual private network. This IP security also providing this feature. Means now here by using IP security we are providing more secure. That purpose that we are using on Caribbean stage, this side in this in Hyderabad center land also we are using one VPN stage, and in Chennai center also we are using one VPN stage. Now here if this switch is receiving any data from client, means any client, any computer send data, that data is reached to this switch. Now this switch is encrypting the data, and that encrypting data is sending by using this channel. Means here we are providing two securities. One is the encryption, another one we are send the data by using special channel. That feature also available in this. In IPsec, what are the main features? Means what is the use of IPsec? Means here, it is provide security to internet protocol. And same time it is providing security to application layer. Means it is encrypting that application layer data. Encrypting. And it is providing authentication. It is provide authentication. Means here, this IPsec is encrypting application layer data, and same time it is providing authentication. Means when one client is receiving data, that time it is verifying that data is coming from authenticated person or not. And here, like not here. Generally, we know this data is transferring one place to another place in packets, in packet mode. Now here, this is sending data by using internet, and this client two is receiving the data. Client one is sending, and client two is receiving. Now, this hacker try to access the data. Means actually, this data transferring in packets mode. That is how this person is hacking. Means this person is access the data by using hash file. Means this data is not sending it in bulk. So that time here we are sending data in packet by packet. That time how that person know this is the starting point, this is the ending point. Means this data is transferring continuously. So how it is now means means that hacker is checking this is a hash file, means this is starting and this is the ending. That person is trying to access the data by using hash file. This is the main disadvantage. So that time we are eliminating that problem by using assigning each packet numbering system. Already we are discussing this one. So now I am removing this. Now we are discussing another. Now this is one computer. This is another computer. Let's supply. This is a client one. Now we are sending data by using internet. So if you are sending data by using internet, that time traffic is more. So if traffic is more, that time it is controlling the traffic. Means we are send data from one location to another location. That time, if traffic is more, that time this IP security is monitoring that traffic and it is controlling the traffic. Means here, if traffic is more, that time some problem is coming. So that time it is eliminating and it is controlling the traffic by using some protocol. Means here, if traffic is more, that time data is slow and sometimes some packets is missing or something is problem is coming. So they are eliminating that situation by using it here. Means here IPsec also monitor or control. IPsec control traffic. Traffic in network. So this is the another feature. Means here when traffic is more, that automatically it is controlling that traffic. If at a time more data, means more users send data from one location to another location, again traffic is more. So that time it is allow one by one means one client data one means it is monitoring and it's controlling the traffic. That feature also I have in this IP security, internet protocol security, IPsec. Which purpose it is designing? Means internet protocol don't have security features. Which internet protocol only, that is the protocol, it don't have security features. So they are providing security features to internet protocol by using IPsec, internet protocol security. It is designed internet engineers team. It is providing authentication feature. Authentication, and it is also providing encrypting, security, and it is also monitoring. What is the network problem? These are the main features of IP security. Now question time. If you have any questions, ask.
What is the importance of audit policy? Why it is required? Actually, if we are creating any domain in server, that time we are providing some features, means some permission to client domain side. But in network side, this audit policy is. Audit policy is defining some account limits, means one account. So what is the limits of that account? It is defining in network side. So domain side, we are providing some limits. We are providing some permission to client. But network side here, audit policy is defining account limits, means. Some users is using one or two resources. That time we are applying some accessing limits to that users by using audit policy. Hello.
Yes, we are you are audible.
Okay, sir.
One more question came in the chat.
Actually, this is Internet Engineering Task Force. We know what is the task force. Means in the internet data transfer time, any person is try to phishing and they are try to mixing any malware and they are phishing any. Unknown data into your pockets. That time, this task force is identifying and they are try to eliminate that unknown data from your pockets. Means every time they are checking protocols and they are checking security. If this hackers is following new methods, so that time they are try to block that new methods. Means it is upgrading. This IP securities. This is a one organization. It is creating framework, IP security framework, Internet Engineering Task Force. It is designing IP security protocol, IP security framework designed by IETF, Internet Engineering Task Force.
One more question has came.
Audit policy is any type of events is there. Means this audit policy is providing some limits to that users. It is not maintaining any event. It is only providing some limits to that users, means clients.
One person want to unmute himself because he are not able to get the proper answer. I am unmuting.
Okay, okay, no problem, sir.
Jagnam Reborn.
Hi, sir. This is Dhirendra. Hello.
Dhirendra, tell me.
Actually, sir, I have 3 or 4 questions. And the question is that, what is difference between sir leased line and sir VPN?
Leased line means, for example, in your area, one service provider is available. That service provider is providing one broadband connection from main, that what is that junction box to your location, and that time no other connection is not connected to your line. Means leased line means it is specially for you, and that data transfer speed is not reducing. Means you are taking one line, means others is not using, and that time you are getting maximum speed. That line is specially for you. Others cannot share that line.
Okay, sir. In leased line, sir, hardware also included, na, sir?
Hardware? No. Means that
wireline also included, na, sir? In leased line.
Wireline.
Yeah.
Wireline is leased line. Means
yes.
They are allocating some specific bandwidth to you. One line.
Okay, next question, sir. Next question is that, sir. IPC, Internet Protocol Security. My question is about this. What, where it is used and how it is used, sir? And what kind of software used to get this feature of this facility? And on which end it is used? Server side or sir, client side or sir, sender side or receiver side?
Actually, what is the internet protocol? Means here,
rules, set of rules.
We are sending some data from one place to another place by using this protocols. Actually, when they are designing internet protocol, that time they are not concentrate on security about this internet protocol.
Okay.
Means this internet protocol don't have security features. So if you are transferring any data from one place to another place by using IP, that time others easily try to access your data. So we are eliminating that by using IP security. Now IP security is providing security to internet protocol. Actually, we are discussing in previous classes IPv4, IPv6. Internet protocol version 4, internet protocol version 6.
Okay, sir. But sir, when we are using the internet, then we are sending data through internet protocol. But this IPC is feature is different from the internet protocol. So for
this IP security, this features works in internet, not even in network. Not an interpersonal network.
So do we need to buy this feature or this is already included in internet?
It is already included in internet. Already included.
Okay.
But yes, when they are providing this internet protocol, that time they are not creating this security features in starting time.
Okay. In the starting time.
Okay. Now it is included in your IP.
Okay, sir. Over. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Next question.
No, sir. Over, sir. Over to you.
Okay, thank you. Audit policy.
Some question came from through chat.
Yes, sir. for audit policy is any types of event is there. Means here it is not maintaining any events. Audit policy only providing limits of users. Next one is IPsec, which type of architecture is used. Means here they are providing framework. This IPsec is a framework. This framework is designed by IETA, but we don't know what is the which type of framework. We don't know. If you know framework, you try to access that one. Means you try to break that one also. So which type of framework they are developed on which platform, we don't know, but that framework is developed by IETA.
Sir, only 5 minutes more.
Okay, sir. We can use audit policy, but only in networking. Then the other side can also use. Actually, this audit policy means now we are a local area network. In this, I am implementing some audit policy in my local server. That time, that policies is implemented to clients. For example, in Hyderabad have one center, Microsoft center. In America also have Microsoft one research and development center. Now they are providing, they are creating audit policy. That time, that audit policy is implemented, means that audit policy is affected to this Hyderabad, means, and same time America also. Means here LAN is different. Now here they are using WAN, wide area network, but this Hyderabad local center also maintaining one local server, and they are connected to main server of America. Now this local center also under control of main server of America. Means in main server they are implementing any audit policy that is also applicable to your local Hyderabad center. Actually, this IETF is the one body, but who is that? Means, for example, I am the one member of IETF. I am in Hyderabad. Another person is one member. He is in Chennai. Another person is in New Delhi. That person also one of the member. Means here, in this physical location finding is not possible. Means this Internet Engineering Task Force means. They are sitting in different geographical locations. Means this IETF means not like our institute. Means if any person is working in our institute, means daily 9 o'clock they are coming and sitting in our institute. But it is not like that. This is a one body. In this, well, some persons is work from America. Some persons work from Britain. Some persons work from India. Some persons work from other country. But here geographically this all persons is sitting in America only, this all IETF persons is sitting in Russia only. Means it is not possible. This is a one body. In this, if you interested, you join, you also join also in IETF. This is one organization, non profitable organization, like your what is that Linux operating system type. Actually, doubt now who is developing that Linux. Means in this, many software engineers contributing their own time and they are developing Linux. But first they are developing one person, after many software engineers contributing their time and they are developing license, they are developing Linux. Like this is also one body, they are monitoring that one. If you interest, you join also in IETF.
Sir, I don't think there is any more questions remaining, and time is also kindly conclude, sir.
Okay, sir. actually this audit policy only applicable in Microsoft product only. Means this audit policy only available in Microsoft.